looking for. Soon as I got on the freeway, this song popped out my mouth. I don't even know why. So either you feeling like this or somebody feeling like this about you. You know what I'm saying? Somebody feeling like that about you. So let's see. Let's see. Who wishing on a star for you? In the game of love, you weep what you sow. Somebody is weeping what they sow. Whoever hurt you, they feeling it now, Cancer. This is how they feeling. They wishing to connect back to you. Did I tell you somebody hurt? Somebody hurt. Somebody is mad. Somebody is out here acting stanky towards other people. Irritated. Somebody like, God damn it, I done fucked up with Cancer. All of this shit. Everything they did to you is coming back to them, but not it only is it coming back to them, they are realizing it's coming back to them because of what they did to you. Do you, you know, have you ever just told somebody, do you know who the fuck I am? Not because you're wealthy or because you feel like you got your whole life together. But I always tell people that. And they look at me like, this bitch is crazy. You know, I'm the witch or whatever. The devil worshiper or whatever they call me. I don't give a shit. But when I tell them, do you know who the fuck I am? I really, really mean, do you know what I can really do to you? Like, I can literally write your name down. Hold on. Then fold it up and curse the fuck out of your ass. You understand? So when I say that, do you know who the fuck I am? I'm really just saying be humble, bitch. Okay? Be the fuck humble. I don't know where the fuck that just came from. Shit. Well, maybe you had to tell that person this. Maybe this person really had to see that you was the witch that they thought people saying that. This person, you know what else this could mean? This could mean that this person feel like you cursed them. You cursed them. They feel like you put a curse on them. You should put a curse on them, Cancer. It's okay. I mean, that's your prerogative. Five of Cups. Didn't I just tell you somebody is fucking wrecking their brain cell? Each one of these is a brain cell that then popped the fuck open. What is it? The Wheel of Fortune? This ain't karma. Don't fucking play with me. Spirit, don't play. Do not play with me. Okay, let's get these cards out here. But then, remember earlier I said somebody is hurting. So this is not just... They hurt. They realize it and they hurt about what they did. That's all that is. They realize in the situation and they really and truly heard about it. But that's their karma. Four of Cups. Come on now. Somebody is trying. You were a missed opportunity to this person. What's that energy for Cancer Leo Cups? This person. What's the energy for this person? Let's think about Cancer Leo Cups, Spirit. What's this energy for? Oh, maybe it ain't in this deck. What's the energy? But this is a chinky ass deck, though. What's the energy for this person? Look, see? Keep whipping out whole decks. Well, fuck it. Here you go. Hermit. Okay. Invocation? Shit. And the Wheel of Fortune in reverse. They are getting their fucking karma. They getting their karma, y'all. They getting their motherfucking karma. Queen of Cups. Look at you. Out here. Nine of Cups. Oh, baby, you the shit. Okay? Six of Wands. Okay? You got an inner celebration. You don't gotta... You ain't... You celebrating within, like, gotcha, bitch. I told you who the fuck I was. You should have listened. We got the Six of Discs here. We got the motherfucking Emperor. whatever like that. One more card for my Cusp Leo Cup. One more card. What's going on with this person? You got two. So you got the Seven of Wands and you got the Seven of Discs in reverse. I don't know what this invitation is. I got an invocation. What the fuck is an invocation? We about to learn today, Pooh. Wishing on the star. So follow where you are. Wishing on the star. Listen, it's the High Priestess. That's the only thing I can see this card being, because I go to Fool, the Magician. Oh no, the High Priestess, the Empress, the Emperor, the Teacher, the Lovers, the Chariot, Justice, Hermit, Strength, Death, the Devil and Temperance, the Tower and the Star, Moon and the Sun, Judgment and the Universe. So this must be like an extra like card or something, because it will take for you to get the special card, Cancer. Oh, here we go. That's about okay. Hermit. Solace. Hold on. Solitude. Okay. The God wandering the wilderness in disguise. The hermit bids you to seek guidance from your inner light and reconnect. Trust yourself when the world around you becomes uncertain. The hermit is detachment from the concerns of the material world, a retreat into a sanctuary of your own making. You will find clarity through meditation. It's probably what this person is in right now. Somebody is in hermit, Virgo. That go that damn Virgo back, y'all. Virgo back. Y'all probably really is dealing with a Virgo. But this person is in hermit right now. They probably don't want to be bothered right now. They're going within. They're trying to figure things out. But I think deep down, this person, they miss you. I think they miss you, Cancer. This is invocation. Let's read it, because I never had this before. Take a moment to clarify your intentions. Okay, this is a call to connect with your guides. Reach out to the guardian of the first threshold. Wow. They will test your resolve and worthiness to cross over. Intimidating at first, the guardian nonetheless holds your best interest and inner growth at heart. Magic is all around us and we only need to tap into it. So open yourself to receive guidance and wisdom. It's making me emotional, my old wacky ass Cancer self. And this is this person, possibly could be their karma. This is probably something they did to someone else. But this person really needs this. This person really, really, really needs this for themselves. Okay? I think if you could do anything for this person at this time, I think it's just to be there for them. Because guess what? They love you. They got feelings for you. And you know what? Somebody can love you and it can be new. Somebody can have feelings for you and it can be new. But if this person is acting strange, acting weird, lashing out, being spiteful, they could possibly really, really, really be battling something within. 10-10 popped up. This person really just might be battling something within. But they have a love for you. I think they don't want to lose you. But I think they don't know how to explain how much they need you or explain to you what's really going on. This nine of cups, they know you the shit. This person know you the shit. They know you got your shit together. They love you for that. And it's honestly for a Virgo to deal with someone in the nine of cups energy and that's loving and nourishing like you, Cancer. It'd be a little hard. It'd be much of a battle because I'm gonna tell you the truth. Virgos, from what I've witnessed and dealt with, Virgos are some motherfucking liars. Okay, they are the picture perfect liar. They will lie so straight and calm to your face that you will damn near believe them. Like, I'm serious. Be careful when you're dealing with a Virgo. Make sure they're in their higher self and they're willing and comfortable enough to come to you with the truth. Another thing about them. The only reason why I'm speaking on this Virgo like this is because of this hermit. And it keep coming out. So I really believe someone's in hermit possibly and really dealing with this kind of a person. But at the same time, why I'm so passionate about Virgos is because my brother was one. And for don't nobody, for whoever don't know, my brother murdered himself. I mean, killed himself. So, if you're dealing with one that's going through a thing and probably shunning everybody out, I just say send him a message. If it is a beef with you, hold on. Send him a message. Go pull up on him. Just tell them something nice. Okay, because I think they don't show what they're going through that much. They try to be brave and strong so much. And Cancer, this can be you too. This could be something you're going through too. But a lot of times we try to be brave and strong so much. Or the people will try to be brave and strong in our face so much. And then they then took their own life and left you to figure out what the fuck just happened. This can also mean that you're just who you are, Cancer. You are the Queen of Cups, a very loving and nourishing self. Your powers can simply help this person that's in this agony. That's in this hermit, that's trying to go within. This person could be battling the spiritual world and the lower world, trying to figure out which one is telling him or her the truth. But I believe this person or you, Cancer, you're celebrating within that you were able to overcome a lot of nonsense, that you were able to still be the nine of fucking cups throughout all of this shit. You were still able to be loving and nourishing throughout all of this shit. So you have a inner celebration. You don't need nobody else to celebrate with your goddamn ass. You happy. You don't need the crowd. You are happy within. And this is what this person is probably trying to get up to your level. This six of discs. They're really interested in sharing and balancing things out with you. You know what I'm saying? I think they really want something with you. And look, you got a whole fucking emperor. You got a queen of pentacles and you got an emperor right here. And they are willing to go into a situation with you and genuinely be open and real and honest. I think they're just really having a hard time right now. Somebody just might have a hard emotional time right now. It's the seven wands right here, and we got the seven of pentacles, y'all. Seven of pentacles in reverse, I'm sorry. I I don't even know how to explain this for the simple fact. Cassie, you could possibly be tired. Okay, that's why you're not trying to help this person. I think you're tired of being the one that's always running to save someone else. Whether heartache, misery, pain, or whatever the fuck it is. I think you're standing up to that kind of energy. You're not interested in being a superhero, or you just might be. You might come in and be this person's superhero. You might come in and help this emperor out, or this person that's a hermit. You might help whoever this is in this hermit energy. Come on now, you guys. This is really taking me down. At the same time, you might come in and help them as far as their heart is concerned, but I think you're standing your ground. You're setting those boundaries on what you're not willing to accept. Hey, Google. Repeat. I don't understand why Google won't stay on repeat. And if she heard me say this, do y'all know this bitch will go the fuck off on me? And then the other night she was gonna tell me I was being rude, but telling her to shut the fuck up. Excuse me, ma'am, you're an electronic device. If I tell you to shut the fuck up, shut the fuck up. Anyway, seven of this. Seven of Pentacles, seven of this, whatever, in reverse. I don't think you're gonna complete this cycle. I don't think you're gonna complete trying to support and help this person, because something might go wrong, something might interfere, something might happen, but this person don't receive the help that they get. They like give up, or you give up on this person or in this situation. That's gonna be so sad, Cancer. This person. Or they're procrastinating. They could possibly be procrastinating coming towards you to fix or rectify whatever went wrong with you. But you're here. And you're standing at attention. You're that Queen of Cups and the Nine of Cups energy, and you having an inner celebration, because this person need to go within. But sometimes people need that extra clarity to find their spiritual guide. But Cancer, that's just what we are. We are teachers. We're nurturers. We help. We captain save a hoes. Okay, that's what we do. We save the hoes, the bitches, the emperors, the kings. We save everybody. We mamas. We're the mother of astrology. Everybody come to us whether we like it or not. Sometimes we down to deal with it. Sometimes we ain't. We got to deal with our own shit. But that causes us not to receive a lot of the love that we are due, that's due to us. Right now, it's the time that I think we're seeking our love that's due to us no matter what, because we all have been on a strong healing journey for years. I'm not about to just say for months. We've been on a healing journey. Us Cancer Cups, we've been on a fucking journey for years, because our healing is a little more stronger to me for the simple fact we have to balance out that fire in us. And on top of that, we got to learn how to embody all of the queens so we can be the emperor. Empress, I'm sorry. I had to tell y'all this. I had to get this out. I flew on so fast. Y'all don't even understand how fast I flew. Fuck on, tell y'all this. Because you know y'all my people. You know what I'm saying? I got to come talk to my people. I got to tell them the tea. Nine of Pentacles in reverse. I had to tell y'all the tea. Give us more on this situation with Cancer and this person. Two of Pentacles. This person has been doing too fucking much. This person got too much going on. This hermit energy has entirely too much going on. And in the midst of that, trying to sit your ass in, Cancer. Your needy, clingy ass in. And don't tell me shit, okay? Don't tell me shit. I know you needy. I know you clingy. Because, Cassie, you probably go get all your business together, and then you want to come wiggle your toes on your man. Or, dude, you probably run around, get all your shit together, hop in the shower, then you want to come play with your bitch, but your bitch up here going through some shit, okay? And it could be new. This could be a new energy, okay? That's why this person goes in hermit with you instead of expressing to you, which ain't good. I'm not saying that's good. I'm just saying they possibly could be doing this. The Ace of fucking Pentacles. Okay. This person is going within to start a new beginning. They need to probably admit that they really even want a business partner. Some people have to admit that they want a business partner that can lead into a relationship. Because Virgos is about that bread. Okay. Look at B. B is about her cash. All Virgos I know is about their money. My sister's also a Virgo. She in some country right now. She over there helping them people in Kuwait hop on the motherfucking plane to get their ass. Oops. I don't even think I was supposed to be telling nobody that. Strike that. Reverse it. Anyway, yes, Virgos is about their cash. Give me more energy on the Cancers in this person. Repeat, Google. Hey, Google, repeat. Will I be? Hey, y'all know which one came out first? Shit. Either way, I'm just going to put both of them right here because this is the Lovers and the Musicians. Either way it go, after this Ace of Pentacles, this is what this person wants. A new beginning in love, and they're manifesting it. They're manifesting this new beginning in love, whoever this hermit is. It could be with you. It's with you. Cancer, you could be manifesting new beginning in love with somebody. Somebody is going within. Somebody know that you it. I think you it for somebody. I know this just came out in our previous reading, but this is about this person now. This person knows that you are it. And they had to go in and seek guidance and clarity. Y'all about to make me text somebody because I'm feeling too fucking emotional about the situation. And knowing what happened with my brother, I don't want nobody to feel bad about our altercation or what we done got into or nothing like that. I don't want nobody to feel like that. The High Priestess. You're unaware how much this person feel about you, how much this person love you, Cancer. I don't think you know that it's a possibility that this person loves you. I think they're hiding that. They're trying to hide it with the games that they're playing. They could be playing the game, because one thing a hermit gonna do is play a goddamn game with your mental. That's why you need extra clarity when you in hermit. That's why that invocation card possibly came out. That's going to be the final clarity that somebody need. Cancer, you are unaware, or you're just unaware that this person cares this much about you. Because you are so used to the bullshit. When it's real, it's unconditional. Come on, Spirit, what else you got to say about this? About my Cancers and this person that's going crazy about my Cancers. It looked like this person think you too much for them. they think you too strong for them. They don't see no more hope in this with you. Your inner peace, or you don't see no more hope in this situation, but you missing the fact that this person is hiding. A secret. All three of these is in reverse. So a High Priestess, or somebody is hiding the fact that, wait a minute, hold the fuck on. I got to find out. Let me make sure I get this right. Okay, I'm coming, y'all. I'm coming. I just need to make sure. I'm making sure. y'all out here wishing on a star to follow where you are. Come on now. I am. Okay, so either this person is hiding from you that they're stagnant or they're, hey Google, repeat. Either they're hiding that they're not coming towards you because they don't have the confidence or they don't think they're worthy enough, or you're hiding the fact that you don't believe that you're not putting in the effort because you don't believe you're good enough for them, Cancer. That could be that inner battle that you have. But I really believe this person is scared to come towards you. I'm not going to say scared. I think they fear your reaction. They fear your rejection. They fear they done fucked up. And with this high priestess, this person, something, somebody don't know something. Cancer, either it's something you don't know or it's something this person don't know. But it fell on top of this Queen of Cups. And that's what I'm going off of. That something's been hidden from you. And what's being hidden at the is the delays on why this person hasn't came towards you, because they do not feel like they're worthy enough. They do not think they qualify to be in your world. And it's another thing I forgot to tell y'all too. Shaka has been in my room for like the last week. And I don't know where this is coming from. Shaka hasn't really, really been chill in my room like he used to since Medusa was murdered. And I'm not gonna lie, I took a lot out on Shaka when Medusa was murdered. My female cat named Medusa, who birthed all 27 fucking children, she fought the dog next door, and then when she had a chance to run away, I just don't understand. It won't never leave my head. She went back to fight the bitch again. And then my daughter grabbed her and threw her. This is so fucking emotional today. What the fuck just happened? I was doing good earlier. But it's just crazy. Shaka lays in my bed. He lays in my chair. He's in my window now. He looks at me like, what am I doing up here? And then, you know, that bull energy was up here a lot, too. Shaka didn't care for the bull, so he stayed away from my room a lot, too. But, he's back. He think it's time for us to get back together. Shaka think it's time for me and him to be cool again. Shaka, I would consider him the emperor, because he commands respect. Okay, when he walks outside, y'all, I'm going to record his walk one day. And I'm gonna upload it. What's more energy on this person for Cancer, Leo Cups? Who is this person that's going through a thing for Cancer? The Hierophant on top of the Six of Discs, Six of Pentacles. The Ace of Cups on top of the Emperor. Ooh, the Five of Swords is on top of the Five of Wands. Oh, one more card. Can I have one more card for Cancer? And the Temperance. The Pentacles and the Hierophant. I think that's what it is. Like that what we talked about earlier, it could be some type of a spiritual reason that's causing this divide. Somebody probably have a superficial view of society that's not accurate, or a superficial view of what they want, and it keep causing you all to clash. Somebody probably wants you to sit at home and barefoot having babies cooking a dinner, and you like, bitch, I run a whole fucking business. What the fuck is wrong with you? You know what I'm saying? Snap out of it. Or somebody wants to be a stay-at-home dad, and I mean, if somebody wants somebody to be cancer men, they might want you to sit at home, be a stay-at-home dad, and they make all of the money. And you like, girl, listen here, hoe. That ain't what I do around here, okay? I get that cash, okay? Some marriage didn't happen because of, I don't know, because I don't want to say this is marriage. Hey, Google, repeat. I don't want to say this is marriage for the simple fact it's a union, but it's something that's keeping this union divided. And it's balanced. Everything balanced but your religious belief with this person. This emperor is looking for a new beginning in love. This emperor is looking for his empress. This empress is looking for her emperor. That's period. And if you the emperor cancer, then so be it as it may, which I really believe you really just who you are in this deck. You are the queen of cups. And it's the emperor out here looking, and they believe you're that queen of cups. You know another thing? This emperor just might need to love himself. You want to know what? When I pulled this song up on YouTube, the first of the comments was, it was a woman. Go look this song up real quick. Not the original version, whatever the case may be. But the woman said she didn't look at this song for the reason most people might look at the song. She was basically saying she lost herself. So now she want to get back with herself. And now she's happy because she went and found herself. And this could possibly be this emperor needing to love himself. I swear. I'm going to do it. I'm going to get the courage. And I'm just going to send a text. If I'm blocked, I'm blocked. If he respond, he respond. If not, but I'm just going to really ask him, how you doing? I am. I got to. Because my brother ain't going to let me not. Yes. Or my dad. My dad is right here, in which I don't know. And my brother is right across. And then my brother is also up here on my shelf. I got my cousin Tom downstairs, my uncle. I got my dad all over the damn living room. So, I don't know. If I hit this Mega Millions tonight, I might just buy this house and make it just an exhibit for my family members that I miss so much. I miss all of them. I miss everybody. But yes, this emperor probably needs to love themselves, or they're in love with you. They want to start this new beginning with you. They just fucked up. They trying to send somebody to tell you, like, remember me? Hey, look. Got my little drink. I'm doing a couple readings tonight, y'all. I'm lit. Early as hell. Don't judge me, but my daughter think I'm about to sit up here and do this cooking and shit for her ass. I done taught all of them how to cook real good. Yes, I'm one of them mothers that teach their children. I was like, my kids can run this whole house by themselves. Like I told everybody, my son go to work, make the money. My daughter gonna make sure the bills is paid. All my son gonna want anyway is some need. His gang and his weed, and he's going to go to work and come back and pay them damn bills. My daughter's gonna make sure them bills is paid and his house is fucking clean. You better believe it. And this my Martinez, what's his name, Martini, whatever, champagne with some Riscata wine. It's my Bloody Mary. Don't fuck with me, okay? One of these, you're gonna be fucked. That's that little sweet, sweet, light, ladylike drinking. This seven wands and this five of swords. I wish you know the style. I ain't gonna repeat it after this, okay? Yeah. Him sorry, she's sorry. It's five of swords and it's seven of wands. They want to come to you. They want to reconcile this shit. They want to make peace. Look, you want to make peace, Ken. I think you both are feeling the same way. It's just somebody have a little bit more work to do than you. So the question you got to ask yourself is, you willing to abandon ship because they not at your level of healing? Because like I said, I believe, I don't know, it was a reading ago that both of y'all might wind up healing each other. But that doesn't mean that somebody don't need a little more healing in that love department and their crown chakra than you do. Somebody's crown chakra, heart chakra is all messed up right now. Somebody is really dealing with a strong personal issue. So the best thing to do is allow this person the space to be comfortable enough with you to help them heal. The Seven of Pentacles and the Temperance. Oh, look what's playing next. Listen, what the fuck? This is how this person, I'm telling y'all, this is how somebody is really, really feeling. And you don't fucking know it. And guess what? It's going to be who you least expect. It's probably going to be that motherfucker you never expected, okay? Or some of y'all just might be so damn bad that y'all got multiple thinking about this about y'all, okay? Multiple people is thinking about y'all like this. And that's fucked up. Now, that's a war. I ain't dealing with that shit now. And if it is, you don't know it though. So you don't know it. It could be a lot of people really sitting back thinking about, like, I possibly just been fucked up with the person I really should have been fucking with in the first place. They probably sitting up here with a dumb bitch in their face like, how am I even talking to you right now?
A love like that won't last.
Come on now. They fail to finish. This cycle fail to finish. Fail to finish, procrastination, no reward, carefree, wasted effort, short-term thinking. Somebody wasn't thinking longevity. So they ended something. And they sitting back thinking now, I'm like, ah, fucked up, okay? They knew you were balanced. They knew you were healing. You was their tranquility. You was the one that came and everything went away when you came. Everything was happy when you came. It was a humorous relationship. It had purpose. It had balance. It had love in it that neither one of y'all even seen. This could have actually been a past life connection that then came forward. This probably is somebody that was in a past life with you and y'all just not met in this one. Y'all just met in the 3D world. And it's a hard motherfucking world to be in. I ain't lying. And living in Detroit, bitch, I don't want nothing here. But you can't stop a connection that was meant to reconnect. I'm not even looking to date in Michigan anymore. Over it. I'm headed to the South. I'm not saying that it's going to be better. It's just, to me, a lot of the men, their perspective is different than the men's here. And everybody knows city life is fast, fun, and all that shit. I don't want it. I want slow family. That's what I want now. Oh, let me see. I didn't say temperance. Oh, okay. Yeah, you need order. It say order, organization, humorous relationships, purpose, tranquility, moderation, peace, healing, and balance. And that's what the fuck is going on here right now. This person is sitting back thinking, like, that's what the fuck this person gave me. At the end of the day, that's what the fuck Cancer gave me. And at the end of the day, they need this to complete their cycles. They're not completing cycles because they don't have temperance. They don't have balance. They seen your ass as some type of fucking balance. When you was around, Cancer, you were the balance. You made this person so fucking happy. I gotta get an oracle of light for this. I just suggest everybody. I mean, I ain't say run off, have sex with the person, make love to them, or say they everything you wish for, get back with the person or nothing. Just check on people. Just go check on some previous lovers, previous family members, people that you don't talk to no more. Just send them a message and ask them how they doing. I know, Kiss, I know you sick of being a bigger person. I know you sick of being the initiator, but somebody is for once really, 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 really who cares about you. Scared to express it, true, but they're really dealing with something that's beyond you. They don't even have nothing to do with you. I really think whatever this person is dealing with don't even have nothing to do with you. This person grew up in a superficial world, probably. In a superficial mindset. And you know, nowadays I learned this, a lot of people are balancing, you know, what they call them, woke people versus religious people. They really are starting to realize how much religion don't mean to them what they thought it meant all these years. You know, a lot of grandmas are passing on and religion don't look the same to people no more. A lot of people only dealt with religion because of grandparents. You know, because a lot of people don't give a damn about no religion no more. I mean, if you do, that's you. I'm just saying a lot of people don't. It's like so much fabrication in it. It's so much indoctrine in it. And they say yes. Just say yes. Just say yes. Just say yes. We're going to read what that is. Let me get another one for Cancer. Leo cups and this person. What's up with this person? Keepers of the earth. Oh, shit. You are not alone. Ancient ancestors stand beside you. And that's what that person needs to know. You are not alone either, Cancer. When you go approach this person, when you talk to this person, you are not alone. You're going to come in and bring this person balance and healing. That's exactly who you are. That's exactly what you are to that person. If y'all never have a relationship, that's who you are to that person. Okay, yes. 28. You're already doing this. Stop overthinking. Keep facing your true north. Your north node. Okay, let's do. Okay, let's. Come on. We're going to pull up north and we're going to look up what your north node is. And we're going to do a little reading on the north node. Like, what's our north node? I'll be back with it very soon. Okay, do not question things so much. You are on the right track. You are facing the right way. Stop overthinking it. It's happening. And you are closer than you think. You are exactly where you need to be. And things are moving at the perfect speed. Do not rush it. Now is not the time to be impatient. Now is the time to walk steady. There is no rush. What you are building is being built. What you have planted soon will blossom. With every new day, a new brick is being laid. Okay. You have come a long way. The foundations are steady. Now all that is needed is for you to trust and keep walking forward. If a thought that things should be moving faster enters your head, that is just your ego comparing your rising to someone else. Ooh. Compromise is not your friend. Stay in your lane. Water your own garden, knowing that your time to bloom will come soon. You are already doing it. Keep going. Okay. They playing my song. I call your name, girl. That's my shit, y'all. Okay. Let me just read this one. It say keepers of the earth.
You know, like, do you love me? Do you want me?
Are you gonna call me? You know what I'm saying?
It's really your real phone number.
You know what I'm saying?
But you know, I'm a man.
Where is keepers of the earth?
And I came a long way.
He a grown man now.
And the spirits taught me one thing. Taught me to hold on to my love.
I can't find it, y'all. Come on now, where is this card at? Oh, here we go, 100. Keepers of the earth, y'all, you are not alone. Ancient ancestors stand beside you. You are so supported, you do not stand alone. You have a magnificent team of helpers, both in this world and the earth, who are here to help you every step of the way. Call upon them for assistance. They are here to help. The keepers of the earth acknowledge the work that you have done already and are ready to work through you. Okay, they bow at your feet and thank you for wanting to stand for them. to devote your life to protecting the earth in your unique way. It is time to increase your capacity to receive support in a physical team. This can come in the form of financial abundance, acts of services from strangers or people flocking to help you in your work. The only thing that is stopping you right now is your capacity to receive support. You deserve to be rewarded for the work that you are doing. You do not need to go at it alone. Call upon the keepers of the earth to help you in your mission. Open your heart and your mind to receiving more than you ever thought possible. What kind of support do you need? Call it in right away. This is what it says. Hold the card on your heart and say, I do it for y'all. I am open to receiving a whole new level of support for my life and my work. And I call it in now. And you specify what you're calling in. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. I just call in whatever the keepers feel I deserve. So anyway, y'all, I'm about to go see what's popping for dinner. Come back and we're going to talk about your North notes. Okay. I'm going to do a little bit more research on it. I'm going to tell y'all what I got. I'm open to comments that's not off the chart. Because some of y'all is just, I don't know who these people is. These freaked out, trifling ass people that keep leaving these nasty ass comments. Nasty. Ugh, freaky. But, please, just send this person a message. If you see them, give them a hug. It could be the family member you swore to never talk to again. You know what I'm saying? Just, it could be the ex that you want to punch in your eye, or it could just be that lover you previously met and y'all can't seem to find a balance between you two because they are hiding something, okay? They're fighting something. Peace and love.